Hey Aries, it's Goddess Puff, and this is your next 48 hours for July 28th to 29th of 2022. All right, let's get started with an Oracle card message for Aries. What is going on with my Aries in the next 48 hours, Spirit? What does Aries need to know for July 28th to 29th of 2022 for Aries? All right, thank you, Spirit. Let's see. All right, we have Third Harvest, 38. Frog, 17. Feel free to break these numbers down as you wish. All right, Haunted, 21. And the overall energy is Potions and Spells, 28. Okay, yeah. So I feel like, of course, even working your ass off, I feel like it's to do with a side project though. Something you put your creative energy into outside of work that's flourishing. You're about to reap the rewards of your labor. But with Haunted, I feel like what's haunting you? An idea could be haunting you. If you have an idea that's been coming in and out of your head or constantly bothering you that you need to do, but you've been putting off, you need to do that because it's about to ramp up the energy now. So say, for instance, you've been getting an idea every day constantly to write this book or create this thing. Do it because that's what you need to do. It's going to bring you a lot of money. So what's haunting you is that idea, that creative energy, that spark. You wake up every night or every day at the same time with that thought in mind or after having that dream because you need to make it now. I feel like it's going to happen every night for the, especially in the next 48, you're going to be haunted by it because you need to create this thing. So it could be like a literal, so a spell could just be something you're creating. It says potions and spells. So it could be like a kit you are making, a recipe you're making, a food, a drink, or whatever. Or something that you're putting together, creating, anything artistic. Painting, writing, drawing, fashion design, anything graphic as well, computers. But you know what I'm talking about. Put it where it goes for you. You're being called to create this in the next 48. Or make a handbook on how to do it. Could be a recipe book. So let's get into the tarot for Aries. Next 48 hours for Aries, July 28th to the 29th of 2022 for Aries. July 28th to the 29th of 2022 for Aries, Spirit. Thank you, Spirit. Okay, we have the Chariot, Cancer. So I'm getting a fast-paced movement forward with victory and success with Third Harvest. So this idea, this creation is going to take off tremendously, rapidly, rapid growth to match the action. All right, we have the Queen of Swords here. So an air sign, Aquarius, where Gemini could be involved, or a Cancer, or these signs could be highly aspected in your chart. I feel like this is you. Your third eye is like screaming. You're on point. Very articulate. You know exactly what to say and what to do and how to create this. You like, you have a one-track mind on exactly how to do something. Nothing's going to get in your way of creating this. It's very clear to you exactly what it is you need to do. All right, Six of Cups. Something to do with the past. Also children. That could be metaphoric though. This could be your baby, your child. But like not a physical child. You know how some people call a project or something they're creating, this is my baby. You know what I mean? But also something from the past is also being brought back. Of course, what haunts you with Haunted. Knight of Wands. Okay. So again, creative energy, but this is also mirroring for some of you. This could be a child that you want to have or wanted to have with the Chariot. Yeah, I feel like something about the past or a child is coming back around, possibly with an air sign or a Cancer. Overall energy is the King of Wands. There you are. I feel feel like you feel as though you missed out on something, but it's happening now. Whatever it is, it's coming back now. So if you feel like you missed out on having a child, or you missed out on creating something, it's coming back now. It's happening now. It's followed you into the present. So that creative energy, that spark, that drive with the Knight of Wands is coming back. So I feel like in your youth, you felt like you had all these ideas and it's creative energy, and now you don't, but you still do. All of that's coming back in the next 48 hours. All that energy, all that drive, everything you feel like you missed out on in the past is coming back for you to create it now. So I want to say, this is corny, but I want to say back in action. That's the energy I'm getting from you. And it's going to move rapidly. I see rapid growth. So like if you're trying for a child, it happens almost instantly. Like it's abnormal how quickly the pregnancy test ends up being positive. Like how soon? I'll just say that. I'm writing the title real quick so I don't forget. All right, let's clarify this. For Aries, clarify this message for Aries. Clarify this message for Aries. I hope I didn't say Cancer earlier because of the Chariot. All right, clarifying the Chariot is the Four of Wands. So maybe in the past there was a home you wanted. I feel like it's a family you wanted for some of you. And you're getting that, or you're getting the funding or foundation or a building or studio to create this thing. Or you're going to an institution. You're finally able to go to this school, live in this home, or have this business, this physical place. You're able to have that now, or you're able to have the funding to create something. Yeah, Temperance Sagittarius is telling you to be calm. Everything you want is coming. It's here. The strong foundation you wanted, it's coming with that third harvest, third time's the charm. Like everything you worked for is coming back, and it's allowing you to move physically. If you want to physically move, you're going to be able to do that. If you want a new car, you're going to be able to do that. But you're getting stability in the next 48. Also, I feel like a building is being, you're getting a building because that's what you wanted. Or you're getting into something. Clarifying the Queen of Swords is the Five of Wands. So conflict and competition. Someone tried to compete with you, an air sign. I feel sorry for them because they're gonna fail. Yeah, Knight of Cups. Now this person wants to apologize. Yeah, so someone who caused a lot of conflict and competition in your life, who possibly even blocked you from this. Okay, so now I see what this petty shit is with this Knight of Cups. There's an air sign who wants to apologize to you. The reason you missed out on all this stuff in the past, whether it's to go to this school or go to this job or date this person or have this home, this car, career, whatever, all this stuff you missed out on is because this person blocked you out of jealousy. They saw you as competition and they blocked you. And now they want to apologize. Are you serious? Clarifying the Six of Cups. It's a Page of Swords. Now you see in the past what happened. I also feel like someone froze their eggs until now. Or froze something until now in order to have a child. Something was frozen until now to be given to you. But if that's not what you want, then ignore the parts where I talk about children. Yeah, the Lovers, Gemini, the Choice. Someone tried to make that choice for you. Someone felt like you were not ready to grow up first or at first. It's like they wanted you to do things a certain way. Someone tried to stifle or slow your life. I feel like you wanted a child a long time ago, but this person made you wait and go to school and go to work and do these things. But I also feel like it could have been vice versa. They wanted you to have a child. I feel like someone halted a child from you, but also stopped you from doing a lot of things. And you're only able to do those things now. It's like someone put your life on pause till they felt like they were comfortable, till you got older. And now they wanna apologize and they try to lie and tell you that you weren't ready. Really, it was jealousy. They saw you as competition. This could be your own mother. I see a Gemini here, especially with that Queen of Swords and the Lovers. I'm getting Gemini, but it could be a Cancer, Sagittarius. Put it where it goes for you. Clarifying, the Knight of Wands is the Nine of Cups. Yeah, okay, so you wanted to like be a player or sleep around or sell your wild oats in your youth, or maybe there was someone you wanted in your past. That was your wish fulfillment, to be free. The Knight of Wands is free. They can come as they go or go, what? They can come as they please, or you know what I meant. They can come and go as they please. That's your wish fulfillment. You don't want to feel trapped. You don't want to feel stuck. But someone wants to make you feel like that. If you want to go to school, no. I mean, they'll allow you to do that, but that's all you can do. You're not allowed to party. You're not allowed to have fun. You're not allowed to do anything. You only work the job they want you to. You only dress the way, think the way, act the way they want you to. Yeah, Five of Swords. Clarifying, the Knight of Wands. Someone wants to stifle your freedom. You are an Aries. You are the King of Wands, the Knight of Wands. You are not going for that. Your wish fulfillment is to be the Knight of Wands, but you're haunted by the idea that that was taken from you. Someone's taking that from you. So someone could be using marriage and a child to do this. When you want to go off to school and do what you want, or maybe you want the freedom to have a child now, or you wanted one, and this person's making you focus on work and school or whatever. Put it where it goes for you. And someone's literally fighting you for this. You have the Five of Wands and the Five of Swords. And I feel like it's an air sign. Overall energy is the Star card, Aquarius. Now you have hope and healing because everything you missed out on is coming back around. You are freeing yourself from this. I feel like someone was so insistent on badgering you and badgering this idea into your head that you became this person who ignored their temptation. You didn't have fun. You weren't even allowed to practice magic or tarot, or you weren't even allowed to watch this reading back in the day. You wouldn't have been allowed to. And maybe at first you were turned off by all this stuff because you were taught to be a certain way. But I feel like you fought back, of course, because with the Five of Wands and the Five of Swords, you can only take so much from an Aries. And Aries is going to say what they want to say. You're going to fight back. And that's why this person was so like aggressive towards you, or so bitter and rude. They try to stifle you so much because you're full of so much life, I get. So someone tried to force you to settle down at a young age. So they repressed a lot of things within you, or they tried to. And now they want to apologize for that. But it's too late. You're freeing yourself. So I feel like it's a parent who did this to you, but it could have been someone you were dating. They saw that fire and youth within you and they didn't want it to go away. So they try to marry you or have kids with you or settle down with you long before you were ready. Someone tried to like clip your wings, whether it be a parent or a lover, but you're getting it all back now, as you should, Aries. All right, I'm gonna leave it there. If this reading resonated, don't forget to give me a like, comment, subscribe, or share if you're interested in booking a personal reading with me. All of my information is in the description box below. If you would like to check out my sister's beautiful crystal jewelry, which I'm always wearing, her Etsy link is in the description box below, as well as saying peace, blessings, and love. Namaste.